Hey guys, David Lemon here from Groove Digital. I'm going live. This will be a short video. I'll be explaining you how you can connect your Facebook Pixel for your Facebook business profile to over here on Groove Pages. This is a question I was actually asked on askgroove.net. This is a site what we use to request tutorial and training videos so customers can come into this platform. Let me just share my screen so you can see. It looks like this. So this is for tutorial and training video requests. You can just type in askgroove.net. You click enter and it transfers you over here to this page where you can create a request. This is basically my dashboard. This is what I do every day. I go inside here and I see what people would like to know, what they want me to create content on. And of course, some of them are planned. So import share funnels from ClickFunnels and things like this. At this moment, we don't have this feature yet. GroovePay setup, there is an update coming to GroovePay. So I was asked to wait a bit with this one. So this is planned, creating funnels and pages. The funnel option and funnel feature is also coming later on. So we'll just wait for that. Agency feature, unfortunately, this is only coming later on, maybe next year. So we are not going to be doing a video on that one now. However, the next one in line, which got the most votes that I can do at this moment, is how to use Facebook pixels on funnels. Sean requested here, can you show how to use pixels on Groove Pages so I can get click-through statistics back on Facebook? So this is what we are going to be doing today. I'm going to be showing you exactly how to go into the Facebook Business Manager. This is where you basically grab your Facebook pixel, and then we are going to be putting it in the website that we created yesterday on our live training. So I created a live build yesterday where you could have followed me step by step how I built out this page over here. Okay. One more thing I want to mention. There, we have a YouTube channel. So once you go to YouTube, I cannot speak in time, that's for sure. So once you go over here to YouTube and you type in Groove Digital, you will see there are a couple of Groove Digital profiles here. The one you need to follow or you need to check is Groove Digital with 144 subscribers and 33 videos at this moment. Today is May 19th, 2020. So this is the one you would need to follow. So just click on it. Please press subscribe so then you can follow all these live builds. And then also there are some videos that you may have not seen also uploaded to this channel. So at this moment, we have a couple of people already joining in. So hi, guys. I hope you can hear me. I hope you can see me well. If you would just please type in 0 in the comments in case you can hear me well so that I adjust my settings, that would be very appreciated. And then after I received a couple of comments, then we can start. I just want to know that you hear me properly. Subscribe to the YouTube channel. Perfect. Thank you very much. Unfortunately, I cannot see who this is. I have written out somewhere here. Let me just see. Okay. James. Perfect. Thank you very much. See and hear. Perfect. So I have here a comment. So please head to streamyard.com/Facebook. It will look like this. streamyard.com/Facebook. This will guide you through a page where you need to grant access. This will let me see your profile picture. So for example, James already did it, so I can see his picture and his name, but somebody else that commented, I cannot see his picture and the and the name over here. So this makes me basically talk to an unknown person. This is something that StreamYard needs to do to get in the username and the profile picture here. Okay, I received already a couple of responses so people can hear me well. Let's start with the build. So I'll just remove myself here and then we can, you can follow only my page. So this is the page we built out yesterday. And then we need to put in the Facebook pixel. Oh, perfect. Carolee just commented, done. Thank you very much. So we are going to go over to business.facebook.com. This is the business manager where you get your Facebook pixel. So in case you don't have this, in case you have a Facebook page already live, or in case you have your business already on Facebook, you don't need to do that. You can just log in. Once you log in, you will come to a dashboard. They were changing the dashboard from when I was running ads the last time. So this may be a bit confusing, but this is why I'm creating this video so that you can follow it through. James says, you are also live on YouTube. Looks and sounds fine. Perfect. Thank you very much, James, for letting me know. This means a lot. Sim says, like this. Perfect. Thank you, Sim. Okay, so let's go back to this setup. So we are going to be clicking here to this hamburger button next to the business manager and clicking here to business settings. This dashboard was not like this before. It was completely different, but I will be showing you how you can take your Facebook pixel from this dashboard now. So this is where I created my ad account. So in case you don't have one, you can just click here, add accounts. This is to be running Facebook ads. And then there will be a button, add an account. Or you can also click here in case you don't have one. An ad account is important because this is what we'll be tracking the people that are coming over to your site. So when they actually click on your site, then you can be showing maybe retargeting ads. So for example, somebody comes to your site and they look at something, but they leave, they don't purchase. This Facebook pixel will grab them. It will hook them, so then you can send them ads later on. So this is called retargeting. So using this Facebook ad account, you can go and set up your Facebook pixel. So once you have an ad account set up, it's just a simple couple steps. You need to just fill in some details, and then you come over here to data sources. And then here is your pixel. This is a button for the pixel. Let me just remove myself so you can see it on a bigger screen. So this is a pixel here. And then you have your own ad account already set up here. For my ad account is Lemon Media, and I already created the pixel. So let me just see if I can delete it so we start from the beginning. Anyway, it will be an add a pixel button here, or you can click here. You will name your pixel, let's say live test pixel. And then I want to add it on my lemonmedia.online website. So this is where you add your pixel so you know what the name is. And then this is where you type in the domain name from your site. Click continue. It will be loading it in, and then it will give you a pop-up that will be asking you how you want to set up this Facebook pixel. There is a couple of options here, but we are interested in manually adding a pixel to the website. This will give us a code like this, and it says here, install base code on website. Copy and paste the pixel code into the bottom of the header section on your site, just above the head tag. Install the base code on every page of your website. Okay, so this is very important for us to read. This is what you need to follow. So once you click on this here in the middle, it copied it to the clipboard. So now we will go over to our GrooveFunnels, the page that we created. And there is two options. Let me just reveal myself here. There is two options when you're creating a site, when you're connecting a Facebook pixel, sorry. One of the options that I suggest you to do is come over here to the right-hand corner and import it, go here to the site settings. Then if you scroll down, here you see code includes tracking, Google Analytics, etc. This is where you click include in head tag. As in the business manager, it said, copy and paste the pixel code into the bottom of the header section. The head is basically the head. This is the head tag, okay? So we just click here, we paste it in, and then we need to click over here to the pink button. So what this does is that it takes the whole site. The whole site means you have multiple pages, homepage, about us, contact us, everything. So it tracks the whole site, all the pages all together. And now we put it on the site, okay? In case you want to just track, put a pixel only to track separate pages, it is also possible in the Groove Pages account, of course. You come over here to click pages. You will see the pages lined up in case you have a home and contact us and about us and all kinds of pages. You can put the pixels on separate pages. So you click here on these three dots, edit settings, and then also once you scroll down, you will see here code includes. This is where you can paste in the pixel as well. I will not be pasting it now because I already have it on all my sites, so all my pages, because I clicked here and then put it in the site settings. So now my pixel that I put here, it is tracking everything, also all the separate pages, okay? So these are the two distinctions. You can track separate sites or separate pages on the site, or you can track the whole site altogether. In case we did that, we can click continue and then use Facebook event setup tool. You can do that one as well, but it doesn't matter. Let's just publish the site so that it recognizes. Okay, saving, saved. So we just copy over the link that I created. Anyway, you don't have to do this, to set up the event. You can just exit it. Now you have basically the pixel connected. The events are separate events you can set up. For this one, I wouldn't like to go into depth. There are many more and better videos on YouTube for setting up separate events. Event can be a purchase. Event can be a subscriber sign up. An event can be a subscription or somebody clicked into the cart page but didn't purchase. These are all separate events, but this is a quite a complex topic. But what I wanted to share today is how you can go inside, paste in your pixel so that the Facebook keeps tracking all the people coming in, and then this way you can target them with ads. You can retarget them in case they exited and they didn't purchase something. So this is a very useful tool. So Sean, in case you were wondering, now you can have that information. You can set up your pixel on your site, and as well everybody that is watching, this is how you do it. So I think this is it. Please let me guys know in case you have any questions. I will wait for a couple of minutes in case some of the comments start showing up. And then I think we can wrap up this video. What I wanted to mention until you are typing in your questions, that I will be coming live most of the days in a week, and then also all the upcoming weeks. Mondays will be the build day, when I create a build for a funnel, for a website, for a landing page from start to finish. And then all the other days in the week, I will be doing some short videos, like 20, 30 minutes max, just for you to explain you some things. I will be going through the askgroove.net website, taking out the requests, and just answering those questions in there. So in case you have something that you're struggling with, or in case you're not succeeding with a build or something, head over to askgroove.net and I will take some topics from there and I will do a live video as well. This is useful because you can ask questions in the meantime. So at this moment, I don't have any questions coming in. I will wait a little bit longer because, you know, streaming live, sometimes it's a bit delayed. I would just read the questions that we have here. So a Facebook user said, great video, thank you. Another one said, awesome, thanks for sharing this great information. No problem, guys, you're very welcome. Carrie Lee said, thank you. Chris says, where can we find the previous Facebook Live videos that we missed? Perfect question. Let me just quickly go over to Facebook and then show you something that many of you would like to know. So if I go over here to Groove Digital Group, this is the live video that I'm doing at this moment. But once you see a post from me, you see, this is a video that I put this morning. Once you click on my picture, it will load in all my posts that I created. So if you in case you scroll down, you can see all my recent posts. So this is the last video I posted on there, and there will be the live training that I did. So you can basically, this is just a picture. You can come over here to see this one, to subscribe to the channel. You can see this one, and then basically everything that I created. I created a navigation, I created all kinds of stuff, interesting things. So you can come over here and then actually see all the posts and then videos I created. The live webinars are set up to be posted from Donna's profile. So in case you click on Donna's profile and then you do the same. So you scroll down and you will see Donna's recent post. So this is the live we're doing at this moment. She posted yesterday about the custom domains. And then here you can see this is the live that we did yesterday, 22 hours ago. And then once you click on here, this is a replay from yesterday. Also, the videos are uploaded to YouTube. So the live video from yesterday was uploaded to YouTube. So in case you head over to YouTube and you're not subscribed to our channel, you just search for Groove Digital. You will see here the Groove Digital account has multiple ones here, but the one with the most subscribers, so 145 subscribers and at this moment 33 videos, this is where you will be able to see and locate all the live trainings, and also trainings from the Groove Digital Academy are also posted here, so you can see all the videos and replays over here. So Tim Judge is asking, how does this work with Google Tag Manager? In this video, I wanted to show you Facebook Pixel. For Google Tag Manager, we will need to create a separate one because it has a different dashboard and everything, and I don't want to just put this under the same title. So we will be creating a separate video for that one later on. Another question, would be nice to get a Google Tag Manager demo with regards to Groove Pages, Groove Cell, or will Funnelytics handle that? As I said, so for Google Tag Manager, we will create a separate video because it's also a separate topic. So Chris says, got it, thanks so much. So that's it, guys. I just want to mention one more time before I leave. There was a comment I typed out. So in case you head to StreamYard.com, you can see over here, so below my mouse, it says StreamYard.com/Facebook. This is, in case you go to this site, I can just type it in one more time. StreamYard.com/Facebook. This is to grant Facebook access to show your picture and a name over here below the video. So let me just show you how it looks like in case you didn't grant access. Okay, so this is how it looks like. You can see below my mouse, this Facebook user doesn't have his name written out and a profile picture. So just please come over to StreamYard.com/Facebook. You will do this one time, and then you will be set up for all the upcoming webinars and then live streams that I will be doing during the week and upcoming months. So that's it. I don't see any new comments coming in, so I will be ending this live stream over here. Now you know how to set up your Pixel. In case you have any questions, please put them in the box and or the comment section below. And also, in case you have some separate videos that you want me to do, for example, the Google Tag Manager, please head over to askgroove.com so we can see your questions. We can take them and create live stream videos like this. So that's it, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learned from it. And then see you in the group. Bye-bye.